All right. Hello, everyone. Welcome to what is not the Battlefront livestream podcast this time. This is LEGO Star Wars The Force Awakens. We're doing this as a Let's Play this time. I am your host from the Battlefront livestream podcast and Star Wars Beyond the Films and all that, Nathan P. Butler. You can find my Star Wars Timeline Gold, the most comprehensive Star Wars chronology available anywhere, of course, over at StarWarsFanWorks.com/timeline. You can find the two podcasts I'm involved with, Star Wars Beyond the Films with Mark Herlimer, where we talk about legends and canon and all that kind of storytelling stuff, over at StarWarsReport.com. You can also, of course, find with that Cloud City Casino, which I host with Michael Morris. And we spend time talking about Star Wars gaming, both tabletop, card, miniature type stuff, tabletop games, and video games, of course. Our newest episode has just been released, which focuses on E3, the Bespin DLC for Battlefront, and so on. In this stream, though, we're going to be doing some Let's Play kind of stuff. Going to be doing this bit by bit over the span of a matter of, you know, days, maybe a week or two. Just check out the content of LEGO Star Wars The Force Awakens. Let me apologize ahead of time for those who are outside the U.S. You may have some issues sometimes, but I really felt like this needed the music to be able to be played. So, I guess before we even dive into the game, I haven't even touched the game yet to start. Yeah, share the data, whatever. I want to show you how this came. So, this is the PS4 Deluxe Edition. So it comes basically looking like this when you get it, but it's wrapped in plastic wrap, of course, shrink wrap. And the shrink wrap is going to tell you two things right off the bat. One is that PlayStation copies of the game, Sony copies, so for PS3, PS4, and presumably Vita, have a PlayStation exclusive, the Phantom Limb level pack and a droid character pack. But it does answer the question of whether these are timed exclusives or if these are ongoing exclusives, because it says the droid character pack content is exclusive through September 26th. The Phantom Limb level pack will be playable on August 9th and will be exclusive through 11/17, so November 17th. So at this point, Phantom Limb is not available yet, but it will be available as a Sony exclusive in about a month and a half, give or take. So that's one thing. You're also going to see on that wrap this sucker, this little symbol with some information underneath it, which tells us this has an exclusive Finn LEGO minifigure, the Season Pass, a 3D mini poster, and the Empire Strikes Back character pack. The Empire Strikes Back character pack is a pre-order exclusive, apparently. So I guess if you're not getting it with this initial batch, then you're not getting that? I don't know. It seems odd that they would have this a pack-in as a pre-order exclusive as opposed to just, hey, here's a code emailed to you, but whatever. You got your packaging. You take off the little thing that's just kind of attached to it. You got your actual case. Backside has Kylo Ren. Front side has a lenticular cover, but that actually is the mini poster they're talking about. It just sticks to it with some adhesive there, some of that gummy shit. And then you've got the actual game box itself. Notice there that unlike, say, the home video stuff or the books that have a minifigure, there is no spot with a minifigure on the cover and indentation. You know, open this sucker up, and inside is the exclusive Finn minifigure in one of the little plastic baggies. Okay, so there's that. And then, of course, in there, you've got your actual game case. You pop open the game case. Obviously, the game's not in here because I have it in the system. You'll have three things over here if you bought the deluxe edition here at launch. You've got your Empire Strikes Back character pack item here that has a code on the back to redeem. You have your season pass with a code on the back to redeem. And apparently, the season pass is already active because there's a Jedi character pack that's downloaded immediately after the version 1.0.1 updated for me after putting in this code. And then you've got what's supposed to be sort of an instruction booklet, but really all it is, you know, here's what you're about to play, here's how the controls work, lots and lots of legalese, and hey, cheat codes. Go to this website, take a quick survey, they'll give you a code to be able to play as an extra droid and 9-num in the game. I've got the codes, I don't have them sitting in front of me though. So that deluxe edition, $70, gets you quite a bit more than you would usually get for a $70 copy of a game. I mean, compare that, say, to whatchamacallit, to Battlefront. Okay. So, hey, Jacob. Hey, Negotiator. And we are going to dive in here. Let's check out options. I'm going to make sure subtitles are on, because sometimes I'll be talking. Audio, like I said, I really, as much as I want to turn the music off so that it's more applicable for those who are outside the U.S., not to wind up getting dinged and not able to see it on YouTube, I kind of feel like with this being story-based to a large degree, I want to make sure that the sound is there, the music is there. Although, I'm going to turn it off in my lower in my ears so I can freaking think! Analytic preferences, that's just, you know, if something goes wrong, send the information. It lets you check out the controls. So we got dodge, roll, fire, toggle character, change character, force build and use. Very similar to what you would expect out of, say, like LEGO Dimensions or any other previous LEGO game. I haven't started a game yet. By the way, I guess we should look at additional content. You click on these, it's going to take you to the PlayStation Store. You have the Season Pass, add-on content, and web content. Season Pass wasn't quite available yet, as was add-on stuff. You can put in your code and you can get access to it to download, you know, the little license or whatever you need to add. But what I did find was that there was an error in the PlayStation Store a little while ago, and then the web content just takes you to the website for it. Okay, fantastic. Ah, itching. And let's dive into the game. Have not started this yet, so this will be a new, interesting experience here. It wants me to create a new game save. I know, you're probably seeing that little PlayStation screen because it's telling me to save. You return to the application, so both microphone audio and gameplay are being broadcast. Thank goodness. And here we go. Noah, a long time ago in a galaxy far, far away? Just straight into the fanfare, huh? Hey, Spider Saber. Like a buzz in my ear, like that came out of the headset or something. Prologue, the Battle of Endor. Long before Luke Skywalker's disappearance and the rise of the First Order, the tyrannical Empire is preparing to destroy the Rebel Alliance once and for all.
But they're gonna fail, spoiler alert!
As the Rebel Alliance draws closer to the second Death Star, Luke Skywalker has turned himself over to Imperial forces to confront Darth Vader one last time. I wonder if that was like a purposeful play on the 1995 THX remastered. See it? The original, one last time. The Rebel strike team led by Han Solo makes its way toward the Imperial shield generator on Endor, but a deadly surprise lies in wait for them. Andrew? So we already know going into this that LEGO Star Wars The Force Awakens is going to be a LEGO game that actually gives us new story content that in some way is reflected in canon. For instance, we'll see a mission where you're supposed to, I guess you're supposed to rescue Admiral Ackbar or something, which actually ties into events referenced in the Phantom Limb comic, the C-3PO special. To what extent what we're actually seeing here actually is reflected in canon, we don't know yet. But there are going to be new scenarios here that don't just come straight from the film. Just like picking us up with essentially Return of the Jedi here before going to The Force Awakens.
Welcome, young Skywalker.
And old Skywalker.
Looking forward to completing your training. In time, you will call me Master.
You're gravely mistaken. You won't convert me as you did my father.
It is pointless to resist, my son.
Your friends are walking into a trap, as is your rebel fleet.
Aw, damn.
May the Force be with us.
What did
it do?
Close. We've got to be able to get some kind of a reading on that shield, up or down. Well, how could they be jamming us if they don't know if we're coming?
Break off the attack. The shield is still up.
It's a trap!
Who's that? Okay. So far, fairly closely following the films, all right.
It's dangerous here.
Just in a goofy way.
Come on, let's keep a little optimism.
Hello, I say over there. Were you looking for me?
Uh.
Will Gray and Wicket. Slow jams. Boom! Now it's getting a little different, sure. But I mean, it's a Lego game. You can't have Leia get hurt and Han try to help her by grabbing her breast. Alright, so we got Trigger Pull and Square doing some shooting. Alright. Interesting. We got shooting a guy. Shooting a guy winding up blasting off his helmet. Ooh, studs! Hey, guys, be careful there. Han's like, I'm the only stud you need in this game. What are you talking about? So you're punching. Okay, so let's see. Whoa! All right, so triangle is your change character button. Doop-a-doo-doo. The biker scouts are beating the shit out of Leia. And we got Chewbacca. I would hope so, but maybe they'll just give us an explanation that Lando's dead or something. Perfect opportunity to shoot and kill that Ewok, and you missed it. Okay. Mini builds allow you to build different objects from the same pile of Lego bricks. Oh, okay. So I could build that, or I could build one over there that's essentially the same thing. Alright. What in the crap? Hold X on Lego bouncers to reach higher levels. And by bouncer, they mean trampoline. Oh, crap. It's gonna take me a while to get back to the odd controls of Lego games. Ba-ding! Collecting Lego minikits will unlock a new vehicle for your collection. And like any Lego game, destroy everything! Okay. That's not doing me any flipping good. No pun intended. Must have to go the other way. Okay, Square. What is Square gonna do? What is Square doing? Okay, you can blow it up and I guess rebuild it. And this time build it over here. Sure, why not? You can smash it. There you go, yeah. Smash it, rebuild it. Interesting. That is not something I recall from previous Lego games, but it has been a massively long time since I played a Lego game, except for Lego Dimensions. And Dimensions I barely messed around with. La, la, la. Whoa, apparently... Leia's got a grappling hook kind of thing she can do. So, unlocked Wicket. Okay. You can tag other characters by pressing or holding triangle to switch. Okay.
Die, you imperial scum.
Hey, Wicket, what you got? Ooh, he got like bow and arrow. Is that something else I can build? It looks like a bunch of pieces. Nope, just a bunch of pieces that fell apart. Oh, and he is dead. Guess it would help me to pay attention. Run! And he can go inside the little thing, presumably. Yep. And just start... Okay, and nothing he's doing is actually destroying anything. I need somebody who can handle these guys. It's probably this thing. What does it say? What? What? It's got a little thing here. How do you make it say what you want it to say? There we go. Only strong characters such as Chewbacca can pull these handles. Oh, you're fucked now! Oh, I gotta prime both of them, I guess? Alright, somehow I just became Han and didn't mean to. I guess I gotta go up the other way. Okay. Sure, why not? Ooh, there's the red Lego brick! And I don't know how to get to it. Okay. Okay, can he throw this? Can he push it? Ah, he can push it. So that it'll break and presumably allow Chewie to get up here. And I'm just randomly jumping between people now. Alright, we are going to create a thing over here to begin with. As I want to get the red brick. You madre fiete mother. Oh, alright, well that didn't let me shoot anything. Red brick, baby! Like, to purchase useful cheats and, you know, stuff. I can't shoot you, you bastards! You better be happy! Shoot from down here? Nope. Maybe? Nope. Okay, whatever. I'm gonna build it over here. These... Oh, unlearn what you have learned, okay. I got a trophy for something simple, which must have been the, sounds like it was the creating and, then taking apart the whatchamacallit, the, thing there. Alright, I need Chewie! Where are you, Chewie? Chaz, up here, Chewie! Didn't really smash it so much as it kind of knocked it just a little, but okay. Oh no, there's another one, but he's standing by a bunch of explosive stuff. Wouldn't be a video game without a red barrel, right?
Target the hostile!
Whoa, and Han is like ducking or something. What? During a blaster battle, hold L2 to pop out of cover. And square or R2 to shoot at enemies. So you can actually do some cover-based...
Incoming fire!
Except only during these types of situations. Only where it's like a, So kill him! Eh. It's a little hinky feeling controls, but to be honest with you, it's still better controls than the space parts of all the Disney Infinity stuff except for Force Awakens. Force Awakens space stuff was alright. Okay, so now you're just gonna like charge in. What? Boom, baby! Okay. What was that? They're shooting at both of us. Okay. So I got something. I'm getting pretty good at this. I got something else. Hell if I know what it is. Now, usually something shiny has like a only this character can interact with it kind of thing to it. Woo! There's a lot of studs up in there. I would assume this is like... Assuming I can't shoot it or something. Hey Leia! You got that weird thing where you can like... Grappling hook. Can you grapple that thing? No? 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 Okay. Let's... Okay. No? Alright. That's lovely. I don't know what the hell that thing is in. I would assume somebody would be able to access it if they start you with. Nope. Okay. Circle? No. X? No. There we go. Smack it with square. Commanders can order groups of Ewoks to help him. Wicket's a commander? Oh, we're so screwed. I've seen the Ewoks cartoon. We are so screwed. Yeah, I would assume probably the Force, yeah. You would think that you could just shoot it down, though. Okay, so when I stand with the other Ewoks, I can be like,
hey, guys, go kick some ass.
That's right, Blue Hat. This is the beginning, the first level of... Okay, I guess they're following me. This is the first level of LEGO Star Wars The Force Awakens, and it sends you immediately to the Battle of Endor. There is nothing The Force Awakens about it so far except the menu screen. Okay, guys, I'm assuming we need to, like, pull this backwards. So let's, like, yeah, let's do that. Oh, no, we gotta push it. Oh, God, level 2 is Aftermath? No! Does that mean that level 2, all the dialogue is in sentence fragments? Because that's how Chuck Wendig writes?
Yay, we did it! I guess.
Oh, wait! Wait, don't forget these studs! I can't... Okay, now I can build something. We got three places I can build it. I'm gonna build it over here first, because I want to get that... Whatchamathingy. That Dumaflachi. Oh, nope. I need to get down here and hit square, apparently. Why? Oh. But I just
built the damn thing!
I want to build this. I want to go up to the top. Oh, that's not going to work. We're going to need other characters. So I need to help them get up here, I suppose. Can I build with it? Nah, just crap. All right. Boom. Let's build it different. Let's build it over here.
What?
That's interesting. No. I need to blow that thing up, I suppose. So, Wicket. There we go. It's like a midget chicken walker. It's like a chick walker. Yeah, this is interesting. All right, so get off there and blow that jet up again. And let's rebuild it over here. So I can get the thingy in a second. And, hey, you guys! There you go. Everybody.
This way!
Alright, now somebody stand on there for me. There we go, hallelujah. We got another of the thingy-mabobs. Alright, blow that shit up. Oh, woo! Why do people keep leaving their studs all around Endor? That's what it's the Marauders. It's the Marauders that did it. Right, so it's like you... You would figure that all the stuff around Endor had to have been left by them, but it's like the Duloks had a bunch of crap that they just left laying around everywhere, and the Marauders were like, give us the power! And instead, they just, like, left shit everywhere. I'm assuming I need R2-D2. Because R2-D2 needs to come up here and molest this plug. Rotate. Okay, I'm rotating. Okay, I guess I'm trying to match this up. Thank you so much for the explanation! And why is it show... Did it just show BB-8 when I did that? Okay, you guys, everybody up! All aboard! Let's go! Never played any of the non-Star Wars LEGO games except for Indiana Jones. Well, and LEGO Dimensions. I keep forgetting LEGO Dimensions because it's not really a traditional LEGO game.
Blowing shit up!
Because we're rebels. We rebel.
Which means blowing shit up!
I now understand why the parks looked the way they did after Occupy Wall Street was done with them. Because they're rebels and they're blowing shit up. A rebel flag? What is this? Characters with grapple hooks such as... whoever the hell that is. Han? Leia? Somebody. I can press them to attach. I know Leia had it a minute ago. So let's hand it over to Leia. Oh. Whoa! Damn! Leia's going all Chewbacca. Woo! Chicken Walker time. So you can destroy gold Lego pieces, hold square, and... yeah, just... or hold that. Destroy your gold Lego pieces. Die, you Imperial bastards! We are rebels, and we do not value life! Wait, what? As I said, kiss your ass, because, you know, it's Lego and everything just kind of backwards. What's up, guys? Curb stomp! Curb stomp! Where's the... oh, and I stepped on poor Wicket. My bad, Wicket. Sorry about that. So basically just jamming on the button is the firing. But holding it down in every case is what's going to give you the little... targeting reticle. Is that an explosive barrel? Why, yes it is. It's an orange barrel around here. It's the Atlanta area, so hell, it could just be construction on the interstate that's going on forever.
Crunch, crunch, crunch. Why can't I walk?
Okay, so you hold it down and you aim. And it'll take out those things, just like the gold, whatever. Except I'm not doing it. I must be too close. Face it, face it, face. There you go. Anybody got some stuff? I'm gonna try to kill C-3PO before he can do the red arm thing and be stupid. Hello, Creepy Nerd. Hello, Lazy Trooper. And Force Awakens, actually. Which is why I was like, yay, Force Awakens! And we're playing fucking Return of the Jedi. But that's okay, it's just a prologue. It's got to teach you how to play. So it's okay. What voice is that that I keep doing? I have no idea. Kill the AT-ST before you can kill any of my friends. Dang, Leia's like, I don't even need the rest of you guys. I don't even need y'all. I got AT-ST. Han, you can take a breather. More trophies! Nothing like a game geared for slightly younger audiences that to provide trophies at a steady clip. Man, I didn't even have to aim those last couple. I just was like, I blasted one, and it just went ahead and blasted all the rest of them. Where's he at? Can't see him to aim. There we go. We got more AT-STs than a game of Imperial Assault. Yeah, I did, I am an Amazon Prime member, so I use the Amazon Prime thing where you get like 10 or 20% off or whatever it is, plus you get the free release day shipping. So, mine actually came in at around 11 o'clock today, but I've had so much other stuff to do, I didn't get a chance to really do anything but load it. Okay! It's telling me triangle like I need to change, but I don't want to change yet. I want to blow some more shit up. Okay. That just gave me a thingy for doing that. And there's two. So there must be a third somewhere. Oh, shit. Leave my friends alone. Why are you walking like that? You have ants in your pants? That make you want to dance? Yeah, my our old apartment, the mail would come anywhere between about 1 o'clock and 4 o'clock, and there was no way to tell when it would be. This time... This is so odd. It's like multiple targeting systems here. These guys just don't want to die. Is it because I'm too close? And where's the other thing that it's at, that it's like, bling? Done yet. Whoa, that is some serious thunder outside. For a second I was like, ooh, what's happening in the background? And then I realized it's actual thunder outside. But yeah, here it comes fairly early, which is a nice change of pace. Okay, I'm gonna hit triangle and just hop out of here because I don't know what they want me to do. New office is awesome. I am stoked for it. Right now, I'm just kind of like waiting for the last thing to show up. I've got a new video to upload. The Vader face and stuff arrived. That's the distraction. Everybody's watching Star Wars. Though that's one of my favorite moments of Jedi is the scattering of the ships. Whoa!
The blast came from the Death Star.
Everything that has transpired.
That thing's operational?
Has done so according to my design.
You have blueprints?
You, like your father, are now mine.
Child molester.
Underestimate the power of the dark side.
Kylo ship mini model, I have not heard anything about.
Good.
Unless it was like a GameStop thing or something like that.
Boy.
A particular retailer.
I will not fight you, Father.
Oh. Yes, they do talk now, like the cartoons. Which I think works if you're going to be doing something that's story-based rather than scenario-based. And this does have new story missions in it that expand upon things. Uh-oh!
If you will not be turned...
Oh, crap. Wait a second. Oh, that's interesting. So, Luke and Vader fighting side-by-side against the, Imperial Guard. That's a new one. Characters with the Force, such as Luke and Vader, can press circle and hold it to use it on glowing objects. What? Oh! Ouch! That must have sucked. Now it's letting... Oh, and I can force push them to the point where they're dead. Get him! Smack him! Ah, that must be what it is. Probably an individual retailer exclusive then. Quick, Daddy, we gotta build something because it glowing gold!
You've paid the price for your lack of vision.
We've paid the price for our lack of vision. Dude, we've been whooping your ass! We paid the price for our lack of... I will kick yo. Alright, so... What am I doing? Use the Force to fly a miniature X-Wing to attack Palpatine. Yeah, this definitely not canon. Mm-hmm. Somewhere out there, Chuck Wendig is like, but I could have put that in my book, man! On my crappy adaptation of The Force Awakens that runs through the first... 15 minutes of the movie as if it's nothing and confuses the hell out of anybody who hasn't seen the movie.
Wah, 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 wah.
Go! Go! Why is it doing nothing? Okay, oh, I gotta be Vader to do that one, I guess. Here, Vader, you take care of this one. Oh, no, because it's giving me red. For those who just came on the stream, these little mini pack things. Yeah, it's got to be red. A mini pack thing, when you try to build it, will give you multiple places you can build it, multiple things you can build it into, and you choose by pointing a direction as you're holding down the circle button. Oh! Where's Starkiller when you need him? Seriously.
Your feeble skills are no match for the power of the dark side.
Quick, Annie! You dealt with Watto. You know how it works when somebody's got a whole bunch of junk. What do you do with it now? Okay. I'm going to use the force. And it didn't do anything. Okay, apparently that's just to, like, open that up and get something. All right, so what am I doing here? Vader, can you do something? You can break that open and get some free stuff, but that's it so far, okay? I'm assuming when this stuff gets thrown at me, I can maybe grab it? Nope. Turn to Luke. Luke. No, turn to Luke. Luke, grab it. Use the force. And nothing's happening. Ow. There we go. I pull out a power core and bang him on the head with it. And sadly, this completely non-serious version of a Star Wars story doing this kind of stuff is essentially equivalent to how the Kylo Ren battle at the end of The Force Awakens for Disney Infinity 3.0 works, because you're basically never actually fighting him. All you're doing is throwing friggin' explosive barrels at him. Oh, damn! Don't touch the lightning! Whatever you do, do not try to ride the lightning, no matter how big of a fan of Metallica you are. Oh, all that did was give me some stuff. All that's doing is maybe giving me some... Oh, there's another one of these. Okay, Vader, you're it, because it's sparkly, but it's sparkly red. It's like cheer wine or strawberry Fanta. Holy crap. I don't know if you guys can hear the thunder through my mic, but damn. Throw some stuff up. We need to get to the stuff in the corner. Okay. What are we doing here, folks? You're gonna give us a hint? Character's lightsaber is such that they can press and hold it to throw them at... Oh! Oh! So can I just, like, throw it at Palpatine? Oh, no, I can throw it at whatever those are. Don't know what those were. Alright, hold it. Aim it. At whatever that is, apparently. Okay, that just did me no good whatsoever. Awesome. Fantastic. I guess I gotta hit those things up above. And drop the